With Air Atlantic and Travel Line. With six nights accommodation and $1,000 spending money, that's a prize package worth approximately $6,000. Our runner-up will get a return ticket for two to Amsterdam, courtesy Canadian Airlines International, in partnership with Air Atlantic, with $500 spending money, a prize package worth nearly $4,000. Our third prize is a trip for two anywhere Air Atlantic flies, and we'll hand out prizes from Coca-Cola for the Bowler of the Week.
Hi, everybody. Paul Menya with Bruce Steven at Paisley Lane in Dartmouth for the second week of our second round of the number 7 Men's Candlepin Championship. Glad you're with us today. We've got a great day of bowling ahead, I think. Why don't we go to the family tree first of all, Bruce, and see how we got here today.
Well, one thing to point out here is we've got winners this time. Everybody who is appearing on the show in the second round have won in the first round. Last show, we saw Len Morrow toss a 243 and Skip Bales with a booming 264. And they'll move on now to the semifinals. Russell Mitten and Paul Chase coming up a bit short at 207 and 218 respectively. So Morrow and Ailes have landed spots already in the semifinal.
That's right. Well, that was quite the episode last week. Len Morrow, a very strong performance. Skip Ailes, who we'll see a little later on, not today, but in another episode, was just tremendous. Remember, he had the two spares in the 9-10 box in his first string, and then finishing up, the bonus ball happened to be a strike as well. So Skip Ailes certainly setting the pace last week. Who will it be this week? Why don't we meet our bowlers for the second episode of round two? Bill Drover comes to us from Sydney, bowls at the Heather Lanes with a 116 average, had a 240 total in round one. Barry Sowers from Halifax bowls at both Baisley's and Fair Lanes with a 125 average and a 219 total in round one. Gerald Cormier from Bucktouche bowls at the Bucktouche Lanes, carries a 112 average but had 214 in round number one for total two strings. And Robert Slowenwhite from Halifax bowls at the Halifax Fair Lanes with a 118 average, had a 249 two string total in round one. So these guys can bowl, and we're going to see how well they bowl in just a moment. Stay with us.
Further, the fine art of cola connoisseurism is such a success, I've arranged with the Ministry of Days Off to make July 1st Diet Coke Day.
Mr. President!
Yes, VP?
That's Canada Day.
No, we can't have the 1st.
You're free on the 11th.
I'll be 11th.
Is the taste of Diet Coke so incredible it deserves to be celebrated? Will the Prez run for Prime Minister?
Just for the taste of it!
Diet Coke!
Is this your problem? Then go from fatness to fitness with the all-new Spring Action Gut Trimmer from K5, a portable fitness tool that works on firming and tightening stomach muscles. Gut Trimmer is so easy to use. First, place your feet securely on the pedals. Grip the specially designed hand grips and stretch your way to the lean, flat stomach you've always wanted. Heavy-duty steel springs challenge your stomach muscles. Power lifts burn away unwanted inches, and it's so easy. Spring Action Gut Trimmer does all this and more. Stretch your way to a firm back and powerful chest. Trim your waist while firming and slimming problem hips. Gut Trimmer is lightweight and compact. Great for the home, office, or travel. Comes with a 10-year warranty, and it's only $19.99. Gut Buster and similar products sell for up to $29.95. Why pay more? Ask for the deluxe model Gut Trimmer, only $19.99 from K5.
Available at Eaton's, The Bay, Simpson, Zeller's, Woco, Woolworth.
When it comes to beef and cheese, you don't get anything different at burger restaurants. But at Arby's, you do. Delicious Arby's roast beef with cheddar cheese sauce, or Swiss with peppers and onions. So don't say
cheeseburger.
Say Arby's beef and cheddar, or Philly beef and Swiss, and taste the Arby's difference.
Come in and try our beef and cheddar sandwich and receive a regular soft drink free at either Arby's location, Bedford and Cole Harbor.
Hi, everybody. Here we are at Baisley Lanes in Dartmouth, about to get underway with the second episode in our round two. This is it. This is, I guess, what you would call kind of the quarterfinals, but we have four bowlers who are bowling individually. The top two will go to the semifinals.
One of the real interesting facts about this, and it's just luck of the draw, but Barry Sowers, who is appearing today, along with Bill Drover, appeared together in the same show, I believe it was week number 5 in the first round, and here they've drawn again together in the first, or at least second week of the second round. Gets confusing after a while, doesn't it?
We'll try and keep you up to date as to what is happening here in the number seven. Why don't we go to the bowling now? And Bill Drover is our first bowler today from Sydney. Bowls at the Heather Lanes, as we mentioned in the show opening, a 116 average, and had a 240 in round one. That was a two-string total, 123 and a 117.
Well, he's a real one of the real good bowlers from off Cape Breton Island. And he indeed does bowl to the Heather Lanes, and a lot of good bowlers down there did not make it to this particular series. Wasn't able to qualify, but Bill did, and scored at that 240 in the first round, so here he is in the second round. A little tough opening, though. He'll be looking for a nine here and gets a nine. So it's nice to get the first one under your belt, though, but it's really a little extra when you can mark that first time up.
Sure is. Of course, the thing to remember, all of the guys we're seeing today and in the future episodes have had TV experience on the number seven, so they should be able to get rid of the jitters in a hurry.
Sure
and
does.
Looks like he's gotten rid of some of his jitters because he's got a pretty good spare
lead
there.
He's got a beauty set up here. He just wants to lay the ball right in here and right on that piece of wood.
Right on the piece of wood that's lying.
Got it.
Or the 780 got it.
One of the interesting facts about Bill Drover, and he is very proud of the fact that he is trained by his father. His father told him, or taught him rather, all about the game of candlepin bowling. This is Barry Soward. He is another one of the good young up-and-coming bowlers, only 27 years old. Bowls rather out of the Basement Lanes at Kmart and Halifax Fair Lanes. And carries a 125 average.
He's our top average man today.
Yeah.
And has some experience at these lanes.
Well, every week.
Good shot
by Barry Soward. Just an excellent opening for Barry Soward.
Let's take a look at it, because that appeared to be a fairly tough spare leave.
Well, looked like he had missed it, actually. That spinning around kicks it, makes it good. Now the thing is, what can he get on it?
Good job. Well, he wants to get as much as possible, of course. Our first two bowlers marking today, Barry Soward open on the spare now as he lets go of the ball that's on the head pin and will take out six pins.
Hit six on it, but really would have liked to have had the four. Now he'll have to split the three and the six and try to toss the three over on the four. The four on the left-hand side.
Not an easy shot to make.
Oh boy, he almost brought the wood back.
At least he does take those three on the right side and had a chance at that other pin.
One thing these good bowlers do, nine times out of ten, if they miss the shot, they'll really give it a good chance. That was the case for Barry. He had a shot at it. It just came up a little short, but a good opening for Barry Soward, three frames, one and two.
Well, that's going to bring up Gerald Cormier. Gerald was here in the first round with another friend of his from Buckfoosh, New Brunswick, and they put on quite a show. Gerald made it with a 214 total, two strings.
Gerald, as you say, comes from Buckfoosh. A lot of good bowlers out of that part of New Brunswick. He's been bowling for 17 years. Kent Bonbons, that's who Gerald Cormier is a salesman for. Married with two children, 13 and 9, their ages. Softball, and we touched on this in the first round when we saw Gerald bowl. He is a duck pin bowler.
That's right. Oh,
and,
that's right.
So you see him laying that ball down very softly.
Mm-hmm.
So he kind of alters between duck pin and the candle pin. Got a 426, a high triple, and a 179 for a high single. It's a good one. Just off to the right-hand side there. He's got some wood that should help him there. Nice piece of wood across there. Uh-oh, rolling back out of the way.
Now.
He's going to have to wait now.
Even
so this wood, it's still going to serve him pretty well, I think. He just wants to lay it right in there. He has a piece of wood in behind here, too, that'll help. This is quite makeable.
Goes.
Oh, he had to be on the front pin, the object pin, and he was not. So sort of spoiled the mark for him. Now, looking for 10.
Got it.
Gets 10. So a couple of nines for Gerald Cormier. We're in the early going. Well, we should explain once again, the two top bowlers move on to the semifinal now. The winners, the two winners today, at least first and second, move on to the semifinal. So this is a big, big match.
Plenty up for grabs, too. Yeah. First prize, of course, is airfare for two to Greece, plus six nights first-class accommodation in Athens, continental breakfast, side trips, plus $1,000 cash, total package worth $6,000. That's first prize alone, provided by Canadian Airlines International in partnership with Air Atlantic and Travel Line. And There we have Robert Slonwhite with his second ball, leaving three standing. And how's he going to handle that, Bruce?
Well, they'll probably play the one in the middle, I would think, and try to get the seven. He got that, missed the seven. Started that with an eight. Robert Birdie missed very badly on the right-hand side with his opening ball, but he is a good one, too. He carries an average of 118, 27 years old, bowls at the Halifax Fairlanes. And he's a chef.
Ooh.
And nice ball. Interesting to note, when asked about other hobbies or sports, Robert says, I don't have any. I bowl, that's it. Okay. Must be right on the pin here. Just want to play the wood. Got on the wood, and that was the danger. That one just turned it away. Robert Slonwhite. 458 is high triple. 178 is high single. Robert Slonwhite finishes off with a 10, so he goes 18 as we go back to the top of the order and watch Bill Drover. But all the four bowlers now have got a couple of frames under their belt. And as you mentioned earlier, Paul, they've all been in front of the cameras before, of course, in round number one. Bill Drover here.
One of our two bowlers thus far with a mark on the board.
He scores five on it there.
And not a... easy spare leave it all there.
It's going to be interesting to see what he does here. He may play the two pins over here.
Mm-hmm.
I got a feeling he's going to want to be on that one. It's dirty. He might go for the bundle.
He does.
He gets two. Boy, he almost got the six and the ten also. Just put wood around it. Real gutsy shot there by Bill Drover in the early going.
Good hand for him, too, from the crowd here at Basel Lanes. You have said before, Bruce, knowledgeable crowd on hand here to watch some very good bowling. Three pins standing for Bill, as he sizes it up, how do you think he wants to handle this?
This shouldn't be a problem at all.
Basically.
Put the, lay it right in here.
Yep. And, he's a little too
far to the right-hand side.
Yep. So he'll go for a 10 box on that.
Looking at the single pin for it, and that would put him at 42. He gets it. He goes two over, 42. With the spare through four frames, but none of the bowlers really sparkling in the early going here. We've seen previous weeks where they've really come out of the chute in a hurry. That really has not been the case, although Barry Soward here has had a spare with six on it and a 10, so he's a 26. And he'll be looking at something else here. Oh!
Wood falling right in between.
Well, this is a great shot for Barry. All he has to do is be on the three. That's the pin right there. About anywhere on that should give it to him.
Got it.
Well, Barry Soward, saying they're not off to a great start. That's not a bad start.
Not
two
a bad
spares
start at all. Nope.
So Barry now will roll on that spare here in the fourth. He's at 36 and open now. You see it.
ESP strike. Let's see what my intuition is.
You call it.
Oh my God. How did I do that?
Stay tuned. This is not fixed.
Where's the nearest lottery booth? I better go when I'm at a roll. Let's take a look at that again.
They really went in a hurry. You're looking at the slow-mo version. But a great shot by Barry Soward. So it goes spare, 10, spare, then strike. Well, he is off to a great start. And I don't know, Paul.
I'm feeling a little creepy about myself.
What a head for Las Vegas.
I don't think this
now.
Is a strike.
That
was right.
Way out on the right-hand side. That's
yeah.
Cormier, he
lost a little bit on the delivery there.
Yeah.
Seemed to slip away from before he could.
Gerald Cormier.
Here we go.
Ooh. Well, we're into predictions. I'm going to predict he will not mark in this frame. Gerald really has to make an adjustment and bear down. He doesn't want to put that down on the right-hand side again. Oh, boy. He ran that kind of close. He appears to be dropping his shoulder just a little bit, not being really squared off for the pins, and consequently the ball is going off the right-hand side. He's going to have to make that adjustment. Let's see what happens here if he continues to be off to the right-hand side.
Well, Bruce, I'm looking at him on the approach. He's at the far right side. He's a right-hand bowler.
Oh,
that was a great shot.
Yeah, he corrected that in a hurry. The five pin, the last one to go in that exchange, but it went, and it's a strike for
Mr.
Gerald Cormier.
And he needed it.
And that's right, and it's very timely. Coming after the seven box, so you know he feels good about that. Now, Robert Slonwhite, the only bowler not to mark so far. Of course, the others bowled a couple more frames than he has. Oh, boy, it's a tough one. No question about that. You don't want to lay it in. He's got to toss this pin over on the other two. That's a tough part about this shot. Or with the ball.
That's
he did it that way. Great shot. That was just a great shot. We'll take a look at it again. He played this on the outside. It was the ball that came over and took the 7 and the 10. Keep a look, at the two pins on the left-hand side. Watch the ball. Bang, bang, and bang. Nice shot. Now, 28 and open for Robert Slonwhite.
Open, so everybody's got a mark on the board now with the spare just delivered by Robert Slonwhite. He'll take a roll here and see what he can get on it. The first ball is what counts for him, and late action there, but he only gets 4 on.
That's really not his game. He's usually on that front pin. He wants to come back and be on the front pin again. Shot makeable, but it's a tough one.
Great shot.
The second ball just working so well for Robert Slonwhite. You've got to look at this one again.
He wanted to be on
the front end, and again, he used the ball very, very well. Watch the ball kick off to the right-hand side and take the two pins. Left-hand side, they were in a bunch. It comes off the kickback, and left and right they go. And there's Robert and a smile on his face, and well, it might be. A couple of great shots by young Robert Slonwhite.
Funny, you know, you said that we were starting off slow, but look at this. We're open on a strike, spare, and drove her 2 over. We're going to come back with more of the number 7 Men's Candlepin Championship in just a moment.
We've come together. One airline flying to more destinations in this country than any other. One airline in Canada serving more continents than any other. One airline providing the alternative business travelers demand. One airline called Canadian. The spirit takes wing. Chicken and get a free beach ball with every picnic pack while supplies last. What a day for a daydream.
Celebrate the Maritimes with ATV. We're preparing now to bring you live television coverage of some exciting celebrations to be held around the region this summer. You'll also see highlights of other events from around the Maritimes, as well as world news, sports, and weather. It all begins July 1st, Canada Day. Celebrate the Maritimes on the ATV Evening News, live at 5.
The quest for excellence. Achieved. Acura. Superior engineering. Superior service. Superior style. Atlantic Acura's grand opening. Experience affordable luxury with prices from $13,995. We invite you to test drive Acura and feel the difference. Motor Trend rated Acura Legend number 1 import car of the year. Experience the achievement. Atlantic Acura, Bedford Highway.
And here we are at Baisley Lanes. You see the floors behind our scoreboard, and Barry Soward at 56 open. Robert Slonwhite, 42. Bill Drover, 42. Gerald Cormier, 36. The asterisks on the board, of course, indicate that we have marks on the board and our bowlers will be rolling on them.
Well, that's the key right now, Paul, of course. The strike that Barry Soward has got and the strike that Gerald Cormier has got, and Robert Slonwhite's open on a spare. Bill Drover's marked in the second frame, so he's got a mark going. He's 2 over, as you mentioned, just before we went to commercial. So all 4 bowlers rolling along rather nicely right now. And this is Bill Drover. Almost had the strike. It's a great spare setup. Unless the wood, now we'll wait and see for that wood to come to.
It's rolling and wrapping. That's
great. No problem at all. He just has to be on the wood, doesn't he? Well, almost anywhere on the wood will be
an easy spare for Bill Drover.
He's got it.
And a mark on the board, his second of the day.
All 4 bowlers now open. 2 of them on strikes and 2 of them on spares.
So Bill moves around to the left-hand approach as we reset on the right side. Bill will take this first roll. Whatever he can get out of it, as much as possible. It's a good-looking ball. He gets 7.
He got on the 3 pin, but he counted nicely off the 3 and picked up a good-looking 7. Now leaves the 1, the 2 and the 4. He just wants to be maybe here or there, either way. Oh, he had to be on the front pin. That's a tough one to take. You really don't give yourself a chance in a shot like that unless you're on the front pin. Not enough whip down there to come back and help you. Collects that front pin, though, rather, gets his 10, and that's what counts. You've got to pin well, and he has done that. 69-9 over now for Bill Drover after 6. And that brings up Barry Soward, who is open on a strike. So 2 balls to count towards the 4th frame score. He's 16 over right now after 4. He's got a good one going. Got 6. Now, he's got a piece of wood. Now, that wood is not going to do much for him.
Not going to come into play.
Hoping it would roll over and wrap around. That's the diamond shot. It's you've got to be either right here or right there. And he wasn't. So the count on the strike is 18. 64, 24 over is Barry Soward. He gets one of those 2.
Gets
to take 9. So he's off to an excellent start after 5 at 73.
Wonderful start for Barry. Can't complain about that. He'll move over to the left approach now and see if he can get another streak going. Started with a spare today. Got 10 in the second. And then in the third, spare. Strike.
Oh, boy.
And he's got another spare lead.
Wood coming back here.
Wood coming back should make it simpler
or not.
Oh, this could be complicated.
No, he's okay there. Just about anywhere on the wood that we saw this one a moment ago with the Bill Drover. And bang, no problem at all. So right back on track is Barry Soward after faltering to a 9 in the 5th. He gets right back with the mark. He's bowling really well.
Looking very good indeed. And here is our friend from Bucktouche, Cheryl Cormier.
He bowls over the Bucktouche lanes at a 112 flip, and I just have to believe they're not faulting the lanes enough. That might be a little bit higher on these particular lanes here, and I think he's proving that. He's bowling very, very well.
7 on the first ball of a strike.
Yep. This is going to be a little tough. Just bear it up. Yeah, the piece of wood, a bit of a bad angle, but he gets up, gets another pin, so he counts a total of 8 or 18. Now he's got a piece of rolling wood there. He'll watch. It turns and stops. Goes on the wood. He does? Nope.
Oh.
Through the hole. Left a couple there. Would have liked to have one of those 2. But the strike certainly helped for the 8 count on it. It's with me on the other side now. Making a point about the lanes, the big difference in the lanes are that some of the gutters are a little deeper down around the plate. And the wood just doesn't come out of those gutters the way it would on, say, lanes that they're bowling on here today. So his 112 average might be, or certainly I think would be, a little higher on this type of lanes with the flatter gutters. So sometimes it's a little deceiving. Oh, nice shot. He looked like a real duck pin bowler there. Just laid it down so nicely, played it on the outside, everything kicked left, and
that ball. Lines are up. I like the look in his face when he's letting go. Here is Robert Slonwhite with Gerald Cormier open on the mark, Barry Soward open on the mark, and Drover at 9 over.
Slonwhite open, he marked in 3 and 4. He's going to get more help here. He's got a...
There you go, Robert.
Got a good setup here. What'll make this shot here is the piece of wood that is in behind, right there, in behind this pin.
All right.
He gets it right about here. It should have no problem.
Here,
with the shot. Bang, got it all.
Sandwiched in there.
Three in a row now for Robert Slonwhite as he gets on a bit of a tear. And he goes to 59 and open.
Robert is the high scorer here today from our first round anyway. He had a 249 over 2 strings, 117 in the first string, and a 132 in his second string, and he is starting very strong here in the first string of the round 2 match.
Interesting shot here, Paul. He's got a piece of wood. We'll get a look at it. I don't think he wants to be here. He may miss this, but I think he's got to get on the pin. And he did.
Got it!
Played it that way. That's 4 in a row now for Robert Slonwhite. We saw just a few shows ago Stephen Webb reel off 4 in a row to open. So shades of
beginning
Webb happening here.
It's the first time it had happened. So we're on a streak. Can Robert Slonwhite continue the tear? We'll see. Right after this, stay with us for the number 7 Men's Candlepin Championship here on ATV.
Nothing better. Coat that tastes this smooth.
Does a pencil in your hand start you sketching on any old piece of paper, drawing heads or figures or little scenes, or maybe your dog? If you like to play around with a pencil, chances are you have the basic interest needed to help you become a serious art student. Here's how you can find out. Art Instruction Schools will send you free, without cost or obligation, this simple art test. You take it at home in your spare time. Experts will examine and grade your test. Remember, it's absolutely free. Just write or phone for your free art test today. Phone this number now. Operators are waiting. Or write to Art Test. Give your name, address, and age.
Build Right invades! Build Right conquers! Build Right rules!
Build Right centers wage war on harsh maritime winters, defending your home against salt air and blistering paint. The knowledgeable people at your nearest Build Right center march to your assistance with a worry-free solution, Weldwood Vinyl Siding. Weldwood Vinyl Siding provides your home with a protective exterior of lasting beauty. Available at your Build Right centers, Spryfield Lumber Mart, Dartmouth Building Supply, and Ilsley Building Supplies.
We have completed six frames in the first string of the second round match, second week. And here is how it looks at this point. Barry Soward at 83, Robert Sloan White, 77, Bill Drover at 69, Gerald Cormier at 62. But you notice the asterisks, and we all know what that means.
Yeah, well, they're open on Mark Soward on a spare, Cormier on a spare, and Sloan White on a spare. If you're looking at the spread, we've got Sloan White six pins off the pace, Cormier 21 pins off the pace, and Bill Drover 14 pins off the pace. That's off of first place. And remember, you can come first or second to move into the semifinal. That's all it takes. Go to the bowling now and take a look at Bill Drover.
Go.
As he prepares now to bowl through frames six, at least seven and eight. And this is the first string of two. All the gang down in Sydney. Heather Lanes. I would say everybody on Cape Breton Island from Lewisburg to Mabu, Nova Scotia.
You bet.
Are rooting for this guy.
Oh, ooh.
All right. Where do you want to hang tough here? He would really like to get all three of these. He really got badly off the left there. Well, you see the bowlers, Sloan White and Soward, and they're cheering him on. They know that he could just get out of the groove there all together and get way off to the left-hand side. And even though the competitors, the other bowlers, want to see everybody do well.
Wow.
This is going to set up an interesting shot here. This is, well, we're going to have to wait till the wood stops moving. Well,
yeah, wood just laid against the seven.
Yeah, so. All this is no problem at all as long as he's on this pin. Right here might be a problem. He's got to get this wood laying this way over there somehow. That might be tough. Played it with the ball. Great shot. We'll take another look at that one. That's just a great shot for Bill Drover. He got in the rut, bowled very poorly in the frame before that, but watch this shot. Look at the ball. Kicking left.
There,
oh,
ball.
That's a great shot.
Well, he had a lot to work with there. He made the most of it, that's for sure.
He sure did.
And that brings up...
Well, Barry Soward, who's been on a tear, is at 83, 23 over, and he's open now in a spare.
Here it is.
Oh! Oh! Barry Soward hits
the
it perfect and picks up his seconds of strike. We'll look at it again. And they go in a hurry, even the slow-motion version. Look at that. There's your perfect hit. The back row disappearing. And he has really got something going now. He's at 103 and open on a strike after seven.
That is an impressive clip. Barry Soward. Two balls and a strike.
Oh, and get on the object pin.
Needed a little more action to get that 10, but he's got some wood to work with.
You talk about prediction. This is a tough shot. He's got to toss his pin all the way over by splitting these two.
Mm-hmm.
I feel he's going to make this one. This is a real tough shot, but he's on a roll right now.
His prediction is...
Oh, it made a line there. I'll go back after the 10. I'll leave the predicting up to you, Paul. 122 for Barry Soward after eight. He's just got an excellent string going.
That's a very terrific clip for him. His average is 125, so he's a pin away from destroying that. And he's still got another couple of boxes to bowl. That brings up Gerald Cormier. Gerald, who is struggling a little bit, but is open on a mark and gets eight for it.
A big count of eight there, and that is a big count. Gerald Rurdy would like to convert here. He's 32 pins behind Barry Sauer. He's certainly in contention for second place.
Oh. Boy, he's had a problem like that today, missing.
Well, he may, when this match is over, look back to the seventh frame, first string, and remember that he missed the three and the six. It's bad. Because I bet may come back to haunt him. Only time will tell. And you may know already. But he did come back and get the 10, which is important. So he's coming.
If I know, I'll never tell.
Once a 7.
Buddy English there, not going to get the 7.
No. He's got a tough shot here. He'll probably try to get something on the end of the wood. He's got to get something over there. He may try to get something over here and bring the ball across. Now
he's going for the right side.
Yeah, that was pretty tough, no matter how you cut it. Now he's got a piece of wood there that might not be that friendly to him.
It's got to be accurate here.
Once you get up high, gets down low.
Misses
on the hand side, yeah. A 10 and a 9 for Gerald Cormier puts him at 89 now and brings up the hottest man of the bunch right now, Robert Slonwhite. He had a spare in the third, spare in the fourth. He spared in the fifth, and in the sixth frame, he got a spare, and he's open on that right now.
So he's on a 4 streak and has a sleeper behind the front pin there. That's the 1 pin.
Yeah, he's got the 4 horsemen and the 9 in behind. Well, that's not all that bad. Not all that great right now either.
Nope.
The streak comes to an end. Yeah,
yep. 4.
A tough shot coming back here. Drive that pin right straight back to the one behind him.
Oh.
It's a tough one to get, that one. Yeah. But, he does come up with a 9. Now Slonwhite will switch over to the opposite lane. He's at 91 after 7, so he's 21 over. Chases Barry Sauer for top spot.
Headbin.
Oh, yeah. Great late action coming in from behind. Sets up an excellent spare chance. Nothing fancy here. Just 1 pin down there. That being the 4. Look at the concentration. There you see the pin. Delivery.
Oh.
And the miss. Sometimes what happens there, when you have wood off of the right-hand side, you say, well, if I'm going to miss it, I want to miss it on the right because I might get lucky come off the wood. And you do miss it on the right. This chase went through the hole. A 10 for Robert Slonwhite. He continues to bowl well, though, at 101 after 8, so he's 21 up.
Plenty of marks on the board. We've got 2 frames remaining in the first string. You all know Barry Sauer is off to a tremendous pace. He opened with a spare. That was an indication of things to come. The only bowler who marked in his first frame. And then he added a spare in the third. Strike in the fourth, spares in the sixth, and then strike in the seventh. So Barry Sauer at 122, well above par, having only bowled 8 frames. This is a 2-string affair, of course, and as we have mentioned, 2 bowlers will go on to what we call the semifinals. 2 bowlers will retire to the comfort of their living room armchair and watch the remainder of the series. Plenty of prizes up for grabs, cash, 13,000 prize package in total. We'll tell you a little bit more about that later. Let's stand by, though, for the final 2 frames of the first string, and we'll get right to them after these messages. Stay with us.
Sensation of Sprite and get a chance to win a sensational sombrella from Sprite. Details at participating retailers.
Now you can find great recipe ideas by mail with McCall's Cooking School.
Cookbooks Cooking America. McCall's is Cooking America. Salads, desserts, and more. When McCall's does the cooking, you're looking good.
Great Dr. Orange, Mom.
McCall's McCall's can make cooking easy and enjoyable with our kitchen-tested recipes. Call now and get 12, this binder, and McCall's Cookery Guide free.
They're the closest thing to foolproof I've seen.
We'll send another set of recipes on 15-day approval for only $5.25 plus $1.25 delivery. Total $6.50. You get two sets every 4 weeks on 15-day approval at $5.25 each plus $1.25 delivery. Total $6.50 with McCall's Cookery free. Cancel anytime for easy cooking.
Call McCall's now.
And we'll send McCall's Cooking School to you.
When McCall's does the cooking, you're looking good.
Bud McDonald Pontiac Buick GMC, the price leader. Compare the red-hot Firefly as low as $7,557. Dealer delivered with a 3-year, 60,000-kilometer protection plan. Pontiac 6000 sizzles with prices as low as $13,475. Heat up your summer with the 88 Tempest, starting as low as $11,507. Aerodynamic styling, seats 5 in comfort. Summer has arrived at Bud McDonald Pontiac Buick GMC in Sackville, where we dare you to compare.
And we're back at Baisley Lanes in Dartmouth, the number 7 men's candlepin championship in ATV. There you see the total scoreboard after 8 frames. First string, 122, Barry Soward, Robert Slomwhite, 101, Gerald Cormier, 89, and with an asterisk, that is open, Bill Drover, 86.
Well, that's the good news for Bill Drover. He may be trailing right now, but he is open on a mark, and he'll be up in just a moment to bowl on that mark. But first, we're going to take a look at it, because it was a dandy.
It was really
served and went. Look at this shot. Now watch the ball. It'll kick off to the left-hand side, right straight across. That wood takes care of the other two, but bang, over on the wood, and down it goes. A big mark for Bill Drover in the eighth frame, and now we'll watch Bill as he bowls on that to see what he gets.
Tries to take advantage of that for the most possible pins. This is the ball that counts. He'd love to have a strike, but he certainly will not be pleased with that.
He got off to the right-hand side. And just punched through, got a couple. That's a tough break. That's right back it on that front end. This time he did.
That's away.
So close.
So now he goes for 10.
Would have been such a great recovery. But he wanted to load that mark up so badly. But settled for a 10 there. Well, he'll cross over to complete a string on the opposite lane. And what Bill is thinking now, he's at 98. He's 8 over. He's bowling well. But his competition is bowling just that much better, so he really wants to think mark here.
I'd be very happy with a 98 after 9.
Oh, boy.
This caliber of bowling.
He needs some help here, Paul, but that wood is not going to get it either. That is really a shame. He hit that pretty good, but there's virtually little chance he's going to be able to make this, at least convert it. He's watching the wood. I'm not convinced I wouldn't try and bring the wood into play. I just don't know how he's going to get it any other way.
5-9 and
5
10.
On the outside.
On the 5,
oh, boy,
takes the 9.
That was
so
I
close.
I want to tell you, that was just a great, great shot.
For an impossible shot, yeah. He made the most of it.
He really did. He deserved to make it. Listen to the hand he gets. He gets a good hand from the crowd. Finishes off with a 108, but that was one of the real toughest conversions we've seen in a long time, and he almost made it.
It would have been the shot of the day if he had.
Okay, Barry Soward up now. He's just rolling at 122 after 8.
42 over, Bill Barry Soward is, and he has a tough shot here. How would you play that, Bruce?
Well, he wants to get on the front pin, no question about that, and drive it across there, let the ball take care of this. It's not going to be easy. No, it had to be on the front pin. He'll play the 2, the 6, and the 10 on the right-hand side now. And play this one for an 8. If he gets them both, that'll put him at 130. It didn't. 129. Correction, 130. He got them both, would have made 131. So he does go to 130. And he's bowling now in the 10th.
Oh! Language.
Yeah,
nothing.
He's going to get some wood coming back here, I think, but that far piece of wood out on the right-hand side.
No, just wait to see.
Oh, dear. This is kind of turning into a nightmare, but now it's getting better. He wants that wood right out of there altogether. He's okay. He can see that pin. He's going to be all right here. He can, in fact, come off the end of that pin and perhaps still make it just a very small. Uh-oh. Got it.
Got it.
Ooh. So Barry Soward goes to 140 and will throw the bonus ball here in the 10th. in his first string. It's a two-string affair. The first and second place bowlers today to move on to the semifinal in this, the number seven men's candlepin championship. Barry Soward.
On the head pin.
Good count of seven, though. He'll take it. 147. Barry Soward gets a good round of applause. That'll set him up very nicely as he prepares in a few moments to start his second string.
147. Very impressive first string for Barry.
Barry Gerald Cormier right now. He's nine over at 89. Balling here. He'd like to have a mark in the ninth or the tenth. He'd like to mark in both, actually, but he'd really like to have at least one mark. He's got the nine pin in behind there, Paulette. That might be a bit of a problem, but he does have a piece of wood that could help him.
Oh, good shot.
Carried through with the ball and got the nine in behind. That's a real good bowling shot. And again, he lays that ball down. Watching this bowler, I think you pick up right away he's either a duck pin or a five pin bowler. It is a duck pin bowler, he is. A little different style, it sure works.
Here it is.
On the head pin.
Hit nine. Will he get ten? But no. Well, he's setting up a spare again. I like the way this guy bowls. He's a real tough competitor. 108 after nine.
This is the way to go.
Now, he's got a nice little guy. The thing he doesn't want to do is get up too. He doesn't want to get up too high on this piece of wood here. He's got to play that one down real low. Looks like he might be able to miss it and still get it. That's what he'd prefer, but or maybe right off the tip. But he's got to be careful.
Got it.
Great shot. Played that letter perfect.
Exactly what he wants to do. Yeah, go out in a flurry. So Gerald Cormier now with the bonus ball.
Well, that puts him at 118 and open. And Robert Slonwhite is at 101 after eight. He'll be up next. See if he can load this up. Looks good. Oh, what a finish. Gerald Cormier gets a spare in the ninth, spare in the tenth, and then gets the strike on it. You'll see it again.
Let's take a look at that one more time. You said it earlier, Bruce. That really underlines his spirit of competitiveness, finding his groove at the most important time as we watch the pins drop.
Oh, yeah.
Great. Gerald Cormier's bonus shot.
Now, Robert Slonwhite. He was kind of coasting along nicely. He's at 101. I mean, the guy's 21 pins over, and he's worried. Oh, boy, that is really tough. Now, how quickly it can change. Cormier finishes with a 128. So now Slonwhite's got a mark to catch him. Of course, we're only talking the first string of two. Oh, dear. Really tough. Slonwhite had something going in the third, fourth, fifth, and the sixth when he marked in all those frames. Once you get over this with at least an eight, will he get it? No. Seven for Robert Slonwhite. He goes to 108. What he needs now is a strike and a spare on it.
Okay.
Would tie him for second place.
See if he can do it. I don't anticipate a strike here.
Well, he can get a spare with a strike on it.
Yeah.
He's certainly in line for that right now.
I would do it. Just got a good leave here. Lots of wood in the back.
He's left the 3, 6, and 10. There they are. May play this on the outside and try to drive everything through. There's the shot. No, but that
gets it.
All right.
Well, this sets up something interesting.
Oh, yeah. Really, when you look at this, if this was the completion of the second string, what we'd be saying now is he needs a strike to tie for second place, of course, a playoff, rather. But, of course, this is only the first string, the halfway mark, but he would like to get a big count here, preferably the strike to tie him for second. Here's the ball.
On the
eight. He came so close. Great, great finish for Robert Slonwhite, and likewise for Gerald Cormier just a moment ago. Things are really heating up, and we are really getting set up now to prepare for the second string.
I can hardly wait to get to it. We'll be back with the second string right after these messages. Stay with us.
Is this your stomach or this? Well, turn it into this or this with the Flab Blaster. It's from the fitness experts, so don't settle for anything less. The Flab Blaster works to flatten and tighten your stomach. In no time, you'll feel younger, attractive, and oh, so firm. If you can do sit-ups, you can use the Flab Blaster. Just put your feet in the stirrups, grab onto the hand grips, and let the power coil focus your energy where it does the most good. Use the Flab Blaster this way to tighten the muscles of your upper abdomen. Use it this way to concentrate on the muscles in your lower stomach. Nothing shapes your tummy like the Flab Blaster, and it's only $19.99. But wait, order now, and we'll give you a second Flab Blaster for only a dollar. You heard right, $1. That means you get two for just $20.99. Order yours now and use it for 30 days. You'll see dramatic results, or you'll see a complete refund. So order your Flab Blaster now. It's only $19.99. Two for $20.99.
Visa, MasterCard, COD charges, call 1-902-539-2533 or save COD charges by sending $19.99 for one or just $20.99 for two, plus $6 postage and handling to Flab Blaster, P.O. Box 1120, Armdale, Nova Scotia. Call now. Operators are standing by. Remember, this offer could end without notice.
Let it be known that this Monday shall be declared Mad Monday at all Madman McKay locations across Nova Scotia. From 12 noon to 12 midnight, this gigantic sale of 12 straight hours will have Madman McKay pricing on all color televisions, VCRs, microwave ovens, home appliances, portable car and stereo equipment, and more. Purchase anything over $500. Pay no money down, no payments, not one penny interest for 6 months on approved credit. Mad Monday, this Monday at all Madman McKay's.
Back at Baisley Lanes in Dartmouth, the number 7 Men's Candlepin Championship. There you see the total score after one string. Barry Soward, 147. He's been hot. Gerald Cormier at 128. Flurry in the end to bring him close. Robert Slonwhite as well, a flurry in the end with 126. And Bill Drover at 108, struggling a bit, but certainly not out of the contest yet, as we have 10 complete frames to go before this day is out.
What's really interesting about this is that Barry Soward tossed a 147, and he's not saving it by any stretch of the imagination, because in third place is Robert Slonwhite, and he's only 19 pins behind Soward, so Barry can't let up at all. This is the guy that's really got to get it going. He is 20 pins out of second place, and that's what he's trying to do right now, is get to that second place plateau and secure it. But,
four horsemen.
Yeah.
Bill Drover, as he goes on,
yeah,
and gets the
great shot. Boy, you can make that shot, and then you can make the shot, and that was letter perfect. They just exploded the 1, 3, 6, and the 10. Watch how quickly these four pins disappear, but you cannot play that shot any better than that.
He did it with conviction.
I tell you what, that's a great mental boost for Bill Drover to start the second string.
He needed a good-looking ball there.
Look, but he deserves so much more. Now,
5, 7, and 10, and he's got wood there on the right. What would you say he should do there?
He may just try to lay it right in there. Now, the question is, will the ball get over and get
exactly
the 7? This will certainly go right across and take those. Let's see what he went the other way. I think he probably played the right shot, because the other way, I just don't think the ball would have caromed over enough to take the 7. He hangs top and gets his 10. And that's not bad for Bill Drover to start off. He goes to 27-7 over to start.
He needed it.
Yeah.
Well, that brings up Barry Soward, who has been so hot in this contest, dominating, really, opening with a spare and ending with a spare, throwing a couple of strikes in there in between, but chopping through the middle this time and leaving 6 pins standing.
That's exactly what Barry didn't want to open. He had the big string, 147, but as we mentioned a moment ago, he's anything but safe. You'd really like to come over this with at least a 9. Nice shot on the right-hand side. If he gets a 10, that's all that much better. Certainly not much chance to mark with this split. Let's see if he can get these 3. He gets 2 or 3. That's not so bad. Barry Soward under a little pressure, performing very, very well.
So we're going to bring Barry to the left side approach now and see what he can do with this set of pins. Trivia question. How many set of pins in each lane? How many pins in each lane? Yeah.
Good question.
Maybe we'll answer that later in the show.
Yeah, now I'll tell you one thing. They do vary to a degree.
That's right.
But there is normally a set amount that the riders like to have. Look at this. Good setup here for Barry Soward. Right on the red band. Uh-oh. Got too low.
Nearly got it unlucked.
Well, he can afford a miss. But not too many.
At the same time, yeah, he can't relax.
No, not at all. It's one of those. It's not the end of the world, but he doesn't want to miss too many of those. Still have it with a 10, 19 for the first two. That's the big thing about Barry Sauer. He doesn't want any five or six boxes. They can really hurt you.
You saw him tap palms on the way as Gerald stepped up and Barry sat down. It's competitive, but friendly competition. Yeah. Really the etiquette of bowling, to treat others as you would have them treat you.
Gerald really needs some help here with this wooden. He's not going to get it, I don't think. In fact, it's going to get worse.
But he's looking back at the crowd now.
The guy that finished so strong with the spare and the ninth, spare and the tenth, and then the strike on that spare. But he's trying to play this well off to the left, right-hand side, rather. Somewhere over here, try to get things to come across. But that's a tough shot. Oh, he went the other way.
Well, maybe he didn't. He caught the pins in the middle.
Come back now and go for the five pin. No. They're off to the right-hand side. That's an eight box for Gerald Cormier to start the second straight. See what he can do here. He would have liked to keep right on going after the 10th frame. Let me bowl my next string now.
Well, he better start a streak, because that's not a bad way to start a streak.
He was listening to you.
Yeah.
Now, wood should not be a factor here at all. He'll go right at the 10.
Get that 10. As we've seen today, Gerald has had a problem with his accuracy. If he can get this 10 pin, which he does. Yeah. He may be on track or something.
Big, big mark for Gerald Cormier. Confidence back after the eighth box. Now, Cormier goes 18 and open. This is Robert Slonwell, 126 to open. Just a couple of pins behind Gerald Cormier. For that all-important second spot. Look at the late action he's getting. Nice piece of wood there. Going to roll back and cover. Oh, just barely, though. It's not as good as it might have appeared to be. You want to be in here. Try and drive this back. He would. Not great. Now you get flush on the pin. He'll now go on the four and the seven on the left-hand side and give up the three.
There he goes.
What can do. Got one of the two. He starts with an eight. Well, Gerald Cormier opened with an eight, and he started the second frame. Now Slonwhite does the same thing. Slonwhite and Cormier really battling for that second spot, but Cormier got the spare in the second frame. Let's see what Slonwhite can do. It'll be tough. It'll be real tough. Get the 5-6 and the 10. And a piece of wood is not going to do him many favors. He may try to catch the nose of the wood, get the ball to come across to five. It's tough. That's what he tried to do. Well, that was real tough.
And they say, nice try in the crowd.
I think they could appreciate the fact that that was a real tough effort. He did get over there on the wood where he wanted to be, but not quite far enough. And even if he had caught the nose of that wood a little bit, I'm not convinced he would have made the shot anyway. But he gave it a good go. Bill Drover up right now. Bill at 27. He got the mark to open. Got seven on it, then the 10. He's going to really bear down this second string. That's not going to help. It punches out on the right-hand side.
Bill far off his pace with a 108 in the first string. He has a 116 average.
Yeah.
Had a 123 in the first string of the first round, and then a 117 in the second string. So well below his personal par.
You look at the 6 and the 10 on the right-hand side. Got the 10, missed the 6, comes out of that with an 8. Bill Drover goes to the towel.
What do you say? Well, he's got to get it going.
Yeah, well, he opened with a spare, and that's just the way he wanted to open. But now he's got a 10 and an 8, and he just seems to be off his game just a little bit.
Oh,
good
pin.
Ball there. Could get it. Yeah,
he's got it for the strike.
In the back door. You're going to see wood come back on this shot, and really he deserved it. He hit the shot real well. The piece of wood comes back. Watch the 4 pin. It's the last one to go, and it's going to go from behind. Now, there goes the 7. 7 is down off the kickback from in behind and just nudges the 4 enough to take it over. That is indeed a big, big mark for Bill Drover. He goes to 45 and open. More importantly, he nudges himself that much closer to second place.
Sauer with a powerful ball in late action and an 8-pin drop.
Well, he still has to toss this pin over on this pin or come in here with the ball and get the ball to kick across. He does have coverage on the 10, however. Oh, boy, great try. Just missed.
And somebody in the audience coaching that pin to go down.
Well, he soured. He continues to bowl well. He has not marked yet through the first three frames of this second string with a nine and a couple of tens, but he's spinning very well, and he's putting the ball pretty well where he wants to, and that's the important thing. Don't show any signs at all of really struggling in any way. Oh, got a nice break there. Wood coming off the kickback, takes the six and the ten, and that sets up the spare chance.
Looks like he may sit down with a mark on the board.
Two and a four. Now he's got to be on the two. That's the one on the right-hand side.
He got it. You know.
He had to be on the deuce. And
the four chances
here. He's not going to mark here. He will get a ten, however. He's only dropped one pin. However, Grover, Cormier, and Shaun White. Grover and Cormier in particular, moving along quite nicely. So Barry doesn't want to get too far out of line. Start thinking about marking it for Cormier.
Well, Barry was 24 for par at this point in the first string, now one under par at this point in the second string, and Gerald Cormier having a tough time getting it going.
I want to tell you something. Gerald Cormier only got one on the spare there. And he's struggling right now. Robert Shaun White has an 8 and a 9 to open. The guy that's making a push is Bill Drover. He's coming from the back of the pack. And he just might be the guy that's come on here. We'll just do a quick count in a moment to see how far he is out of second place. But Bill Drover, open on a spare, is closing the gap.
As we calculate, there you see Gerald's scoreboard, 128 in the first string, now at 25 after three of the second.
Drover, 11 pins, if my facts are right, out of second place, and he's open on a strike. So this man is going to be concerned, and so does Robert Shaun White.
It's a close ball game, yeah, boys and girls.
We may see one of the best finishes we've seen in the series before this one is over. We may see all four bowlers battling right down to the wire. As Barry Sauer is not marked here. He's only dropped one pin, but is not marked in the second string. Good ball there by Gerald Cormier to clean the plate. That's only a 10, but it's a big 10.
That's certainly a big step from a 6.
Yeah.
Which you bowled in the previous box. He needed that.
Come on, Robert. Now, Robert Shaun White, he has opened with an 8 and has a 9. So he and Cormier right now tied. Shaun White faltering. I want to tell you. Bill Drover is the brightest light in this second string so far, and he's the guy in fourth place, and that makes it interesting. Shaun White missed on the left-hand side. Big finish for Cormier and Shaun White, along with the big opening string by Barry Sauer. It looked like it might be a three-man.
Hey,
nice finish there.
That was a great shot.
Yeah, sure it was. We saw Cormier just a moment ago. We'll take another look at this one. It's only
will,
a 10,
yeah.
But it's a big 10. You got three big pins down there. Watch the shot. Letter perfect. Kicks a 5 right over on
that
the 7.
It.
And we saw Cormier come up with a big 10 a moment ago. So these guys are pinning very, very well. Now, Robert Shaun White here in the fourth frame.
Robert would love to join Bill Drover in sitting down for a commercial break with a mark on the board.
Well, what's happening now is the boys are off the front pin, and they're not getting the good spare chances. They are converting well with the third ball. Now, he does have nice coverage here on the 8. So basically, it's a four horseman.
He goes.
Oh, has to be on. Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Front pin coming back, and it's...
No.
Oh.
Not going to happen. But, well, that's the pin he wanted to be on at the beginning. That would have hit the standing pin right at the red mark. He would have got that, but it wrapped around a little bit. Just took enough of the momentum away so the pin wouldn't fall down. But it's getting really exciting.
Thrills, spills, chills, and weebly wobbly pins that won't go down. We'll come back with more of the number 7 Men's Candlepin Championship right after this.
I've arranged with the Ministry of Days Off to make July 1st Diet Coke Day.
Mr. President.
Yes, VP.
That's Canada Day.
No, we can't have the 1st.
You're free on the 11th.
How's the 11th? Book it, VP.
Is the taste of Diet Coke so incredible it deserves to be celebrated? Will the Prez run for Prime Minister?
Just for the taste of it.
Diet Coke.
We've come together. One airline flying to more destinations in this country than any other. one airline in Canada serving more continents than any other. One airline providing the alternative business travelers demand. One airline called Canadian. The spirit takes wing.
You'll find your problems easy to handle with help from Nova Scotia Sand and Gravel.
The ideal solution to your landscaping problems. Maintenance-free Nova Scotia Sand and Gravel brick or marble chips. Inexpensive and versatile. You'll discover dozens of uses for them around your home, and they'll never need replacing. Pick up Nova Scotia Sand and Gravel brick or marble chips today.
You'll find your problems easy to handle with help from Nova Scotia Sand and Gravel.
Hi, I'm Tom Jeffries, and I'm serving up breakfast every morning on 92 CJCA. Weather forecast with Stephanie, news headlines with Doug Reynolds, Rick Howe has full details at 7 and 8, and John Moore is on the sports file. So if you like favorites from the 60s, 70s, and 80s, from the Supremes to Billy Joel, I'll play them for you. For news, accurate weather, and favorites of yesterday and today, join me, Jeffries in the Morning, and the CJCH crew. We'll keep you smiling all morning long.
Jeffries in the Morning.
And here it is, scoreboard after four frames of the second string. Barry Soward at 186, Robert Slonwhite at 163. So is Gerald Cormier and Bill Drover at 153 and open. And Bill will get up and bowl for us now.
Numbers are impressive, Paul, but you really have to look at the differences here. We've got a tie for second with Cormier and Slonwhite, 23 pins out of the top spot, but right now, Bill Drover up the bowl is just 11 pins off of second place, 10 pins rather off of second place, and now he's just 4 pins out of second place.
And he rifled that
picking
ball
up six.
Down.
Yeah, picking up six, and he's got a good chance to mark here. He's got 5, 3, 6, and 10. He's got him.
Got it.
Russ, at least to Bill Drover.
Take a look at that one again, because he really is putting some strength behind that ball.
He had to be perfect with it. Bang. No problem.
Little
off the kickback, and that's a big, big mark. Now,
3-pin that went flying off the kickback with great velocity. Indication of what he put behind that ball.
Drover,
look at the arm come back.
Place. Oh, boy. Well, he's got 6 on his mark, which is the good news. The bad news is he's got a really tough split here. Not sure how he will play this one. He may try to split these two here and put this one straight across, and that's where it'll have to go, 2 on the 3. That's the way he goes. Got to make sure on one of these. There it comes. Oh, and through the hole. Well, three-way tie right now for second place.
Ooh.
And second place is so important because the second place finisher goes on to the semifinals along with the winner. The leader right now, Barry Soward, steps up. He is not marked in the second string.
You were right, Bruce. This is going to be the tightest finish we've had. And not a great leave there for Soward.
The other thing, too, you know, you put Cormier, Slonwhite, and Drover all fighting it out for second spot with Barry Soward, who is faltering a little bit here in the second string, and he could be in some serious trouble. Oh, it's one he really wanted. Gave it a try. But again, here in the fifth, Barry Soward will not mark.
Mentioned the first prize earlier in the show. The second prize in our number 7 men's handlepin championship is airfare for 2 to Amsterdam plus $500 cash. Total value of $4,000 from Canadian Airlines International in partnership with Air Atlantic. Some terrific prizes to be had. We'll get to those in several weeks from now. But what a shot by Barry Soward.
That's a big one. Wood on the move.
A comeback wood moving, but will wrap around and eventually fall off the plate, leaving the 7-pin by itself.
Right-handed bowler coming across the lane.
Completely defenseless.
Right on the pin. Barry Soward comes up with a big, big mark there, Paul. Big mark for Barry Soward. Not only does it help on the scoreboard, but mentally, you know, he's thinking, here I am in the sixth, I haven't marked yet. The other guys are coming.
He wants to stay ahead of that pack that is fighting for second place, and really is a fight now.
They're all tied.
And here's a guy who seems to bring a lot of intensity when his back is up against the wall.
Uh-oh.
And that's an indication of it. He's going to get that 10 over, so he's got...
Got the 10. That was a big play there.
Single pin for a mark, and he looks back, smiles at the crowd.
He could play the wood here, but I'm sure he won't. He'll go right on the pin.
Well, it's
hope Gerald can get this. This will be key.
Oh, he's
missed. That's a, and you
might have picked that up. Somebody says he should have played the wood. Well, good bowlers will go right at the pin, and he did the right thing. He came close to the wood that time. Well, Gerald Cormier would have liked to have had that one. Little smile, though.
Good sport.
Yeah, well, it is. Yeah, one of the real good guys.
But one who is capable of getting himself out of a corner.
Not that he's in one now. He's still in it.
Second place. Not a bad lead there now.
No, but he came off the side. He didn't get on the front pin. So his accuracy now, and not
just hurting.
Well, not to put him down, but in the last three balls, he has not hit the object pin. So he wants to bear down here. Get right on. Has to be on the front one. Oh, well, hey, look. The guy says, I've been off the object pin for three in a row, and this time he's too flush on it. Throw it straight back. Gerald Cormier. Got it. Two great fair chances. You saw them slip away. He's a fighter. Yeah, I'm sure you'll see him back. 54 now, if you're counting the second frame. Robert Sloan went up right now. He is not marking the second string. Bowling here in the fifth. Yeah.
Here's Robert on the front pin.
And he's going to have a tough split. I want to tell you, everything is going Bill Drover's way in the second string. He's making things happen, but Sloan White and Cormier are helping him. Cormier had the mark, but he only got one on it, and Sloan White has not marked at all.
Let's get that six pin over on the right side there. Now the four and the seven on the left and the six, and it'll be tough to get 10. Maybe he'll go for the two on the left more than likely, which he does, taking out the 10.
Gets an eight.
For an eight.
There's Sloan White. So Bill Drover, now in second place. One pin back is Gerald Cormier, and two pins back is this man, Robert Sloan White.
Five under on the three pin, kind of punched through, taking out the seven, but leaves six standing. And where should he go?
Well, you've got to be on the front end. You've got to be between the one and the two. Got to lay it in here. You've got to get something over on the six and the ten.
So what would normally be a strike ball is thrown, but leaves one standing.
Well, the one came across in front of the six off the kickback and took the ten, but left the six.
So he takes that out. Now he gets a ten.
Well, every pin is important, and he gets that one there, and a big ten in a sense for Robert Sloan White.
That brings up Bill Drover again. We go back to the top of the board. And Bill is at 79, 19 over, but has a lot of catching up to do on that first break.
Look, you can just feel it. This guy is coming on. There's no question about it.
Look what happened to this pin here, the nose of the pin.
He's got all kinds of wood down there. It's all good. Should be no problem at all with this. Well, except the nose of the wood.
That's really hard to believe, isn't it?
Yeah. He had so much wood down there. The only thing he didn't want to do is catch the nose of the wood, and that's what he did. And look at this.
Too much wood.
Oh. Hard to believe, isn't it?
It can happen, though.
It really is. Well, Bill Drover just opened the door for Robert Sloan White and Gerald Cormier. It's like, hey, you come in. I don't want it. You can have it.
Okay. Here we go with a shot that looks great. Will he get the lead action?
Another nine-pin break for Bill Drover. This time, there's no way he's going to miss this. Well, let me just look
never say
again.
Never.
He does that.
If he hits
wood
the
in behind, it should there should be coverage. We can't really see because this is blocking away.
Right.
But it should be covering a piece of that pin. That's all he needs.
And he should have no problem.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay. Bill Drover sits down to make way for Barry Sauer.
The good news is he got the spare. The bad news for him is he knows he could have had back-to-back spares.
That's
and
right.
He would have counted nine on that spare that he missed.
Imagine how Gerald Cormier feels. Pretty much in the same boat.
Okay, Barry Sauer would open on the mark right here, that being a spare.
Oh.
Good hit.
Back on the floor, and it took the pins out.
Well, Barry Sauer's back. He is really back in the groove. We talked about him not marking, but he did come up with the mark in the sixth, got the spare, and now the strike on that spare. Let's look at it again. And it's a big one because it came on the spare. Barry actually bounced that ball a little bit, but it worked very, very well for him. And I think that may seal the fate as far as first place is concerned. Now, he's only bowling here in the eighth, but Barry looks very, very strong right now. Even though he didn't mark in the first five, he only dropped one pin. Well, look at this. Barry, Barry. Not speak too soon here. And he has three so far.
That was a shot.
On the strike. Does not want to find that hole and take only the nine and behind. On the front fin, but it was dicey. Oh boy. This is kind of interesting here. If Barry can lay this ball right in here, a little dicey, but that wood here will go right across, and he could get 10 out of this.
Okay, see if he does it.
Yep. Yeah. He got it, just didn't get enough velocity on it. He's got a small piece of it. He comes out of that with an 8. That's Barry Sauer, and gives way now to Gerald Cormier. Action heats up. Only 4 frames for Cormier left, as well as Swan White. For over and Sauer, only 2 left. Good hit, 8 pin drop. This is a big spare chance here for Gerald Cormier. He's missed a couple of good opportunities. Does not want to miss this one. It's the 3 and the 6. He has to be on the pin out in front. And dear me.
Oh.
Well, sometimes it happens, you know, when the competition gets real close, you hold on to the ball a little tighter. You don't drop a shoulder. Don't square up. The little things sometimes. So easy with that third ball. A couple of big pins, though, for Cormier. Gets his 10. But
should have had a spare.
Yeah, it's missed opportunities right now. Bill Drover missed one. Robert Swanwhite, Cormier missed a couple. They've really had their chances. But it makes it interesting because it keeps it very close. Only 1 pin separating the 3 bowlers for second place. However, Bill Drover has the edge because he's open on a mark. This is a tough split here for Cormier. Got to play this one for 10. He had ideas, didn't he? And a big pin down there. It's the 10 pin. Gerald Cormier bowling here in the 8th frame. He's got the channel. And it'll be a 9.
Yep.
And Robert Swanwhite gets up. Now, Robert Swanwhite will bowl here in the 7th and 8th. And after that, there will be but 2 frames to come. And it is really tight. Just 1 pin separating 3 bowlers as they fight for the second place spot. Swanwhite. It's not going to be easy. It's makeable, but he's got the 1, 3, 6, 9 in behind. On the other side, the 4 and the 7. It's going to be perfect on the front.
Well,
give it a try.
The 1, 3,
he really
nine,
has to get the
6.
Four. Yeah, he has to get the 4 and the 7 pole on the left-hand side. He's got to come out of this with a 9.
The 6 will stay unless there's a miracle on the kickback. And he only takes the 4.
Yeah, only got 1 of the 2. Left 2 on the plate. And I tell you, it really is a case right now of these 3 bowlers not going after the low. Bill Drover has got a spare. He missed one. Now Swanwhite comes back. Now he's got a good 8 pin drop. He could get a real good piece of wood here. On the other hand, maybe not. Now he's going to have to be right on the 5. He's got the 5-8. He's got to be on the 5. Either on this side or this side, doesn't matter. Does not want to be flush on it. This is a shot he really has to make. Missed on the right-hand side. Well, it just seems that nobody wants to take the big lead. He's got only 1 of the 2, so Swanwhite gets a 9. But I want to tell you something. We've got 2 frames per bowler to come, and it is going to be real dicey and real exciting as they fight for that second and final spot.
We'll get to it right after these messages. Stay with us.
Kentucky Fried Chicken, and get a free beach ball with every picnic pack while supplies last.
Celebrate the Maritimes with ATV. We're preparing now to bring you live television coverage of some exciting celebrations to be held around the region this summer. You'll also see highlights of other events from around the Maritimes, as well as world news, sports, and weather. It all begins July 1st, Canada Day. Celebrate the Maritimes on the ATV Evening News, live at 5.
Bill Cosby on Great Film Developing.
This is my dog. We lost Best of Show at a big dog show. That was a sad night. He was very upset. I took some pictures, remember? Huh? Well, now you don't think I'd take them just anywhere to be developed. Here, come on, look at them.
Ask for the Kodak Color Watch system. This Color Watch seal says only Kodak products are used for great developing.
He's still upset. I show him the pictures. He says, "Arf, Color Watch, you're going to thank me for it."
Summer means fun, and fun means Funland Village and Log Cabin Kitchen Restaurant. 28 exciting, action-packed activities for the whole family. Kids will love the wading pool, and you're never too old to cool off slipping down the water slide. You just can't beat the price at $1.75. So try the go-karts and the bumper cars. Finish your mini vacation with a challenging game of mini-golf. Funland Village and Log Cabin Kitchen Restaurant, Highway 10 in Nicktaugh, 1 mile from the Middleton Tourist Bureau.
And it's almost over. The second week of the second round of the number 7 Men's Candlepin Championship here in ATV. Total scores, Barry Sauer at 240. He will advance. Bill Drover at 206. Gerald Cormier at 201. And Robert Slonwhite at 198. Who of those three will advance?
Well, let's look at the spread, because that's what really counts. We'll forget about Barry Sauer for the moment, and we'll concede first place to him. But second place, and you've got to be second to move on, is what it's all about right now. Bill Drover holds down second spot, 206, and he is open on a spare. But Gerard Cormier is only 5 pins off the pace, and Robert Slonwhite's only 8 pins off the pace. That's how they stack up right now. And that is indeed the situation. The battle is on for second place, and an all-important ball is going to be thrown in just a moment when Bill Drover steps up to throw on his spare.
He is open.
He punches through, only gets a couple. It's wide open.
There he is, Bill Drover from Sydney.
All right, we're all set. Big one for him. Wants to sink it deep. He's going to count 6, and that's not so bad. But the bad news is he's going to have he's just got an almost impossible spare chance.
We got a piece of wood there that's going to roll back and forth, maybe another 3 or 4 trips.
Now, the big thing that Bill wants to do here is really play this for a 10. If he gets 10 here, then he puts Gerald Cormier and Robert Slonwhite into a position where they have to get a couple of marks each.
Well, looks like it's settled right there.
It's not really a big problem. He doesn't want to catch the nose of the wood. He wants to get right on the 6. Oh, he caught the wood. Well, he's not going to get 10. Well, never say never, but it's very unlikely. But I want to tell you one thing. Paul, he really wants one of those. He gets one, the 7. It's a 9 for Bill Drover. He goes to 113 now. This is going to get interesting.
And now he will roll his final 3 balls. That is,
if he doesn't mark here, he wants a 10. He really wants a 10. Good hit. Oh, but he's got a tough split again. Now, he's got a couple of pieces of wood here. Well, he's got a couple of pieces of wood down there on the right-hand side. But they're a little too deep, because if he lays it in there, they'll go over, but he'll miss this pin. So he's got to be on this one. There's 2 pins down there, the 4 and the 7, and they are just so important. He'd like to go on the 5 and try to throw it over on the 4 and the 7, but I'm sure he'll go on the 4 and the 7. He'd like to have them both. Lays it down. Only the 7, rather. So Bill Drover finishes with a 9 and an 8, and picks up 6 on the spare that he was open on. So really, all bets are off right now. Barry Sauer steps up. We've conceded first place to him, and we look to see him in the semifinal.
Now he just has fun.
Yeah.
Because he's untouchable.
Well, he earned his way here with that 147 in the opening string, and he's bowling 13 over right now at 93 after 8. But don't go away, because we've got some fireworks yet to come when Gerald Cormier gets up and Robert Slonwhite. Robert's going to have to get a couple of marks. He gets up, but Cormier with 1 mark could grab second spot. Barry Sauer takes the 9. There goes the 102. Nice position to be in, the one he's in right now. But this is just the calm before the storm, Paul. We got some fireworks, maybe. Good hit by Barry Sauer. Leaves 3 together. It's the 6, 9, and 10. Wants to be on the 6, right or left. There they are. This side, that side, doesn't really matter. You made this many, many times. But will not make it this time.
Oh.
A little too flush on the six. It's all sort of academic anyway. Barry Sauer gets that one. And he takes nine to finish off with a very good 111 to go with his 147, 258 total. But now the ball is squarely in the court of this man, Gerald Cormier. Mark with nine on it, a couple of tens. That'll put him into second place. But he does have to mark. There's no doubt about that. Oh, boy, it's not going to be easy. It's not going to be easy this time. He's got to come right back and try to get on the front end. Throw the strike ball, split the one and the two. You see it?
And you see the delivery now?
It's the ball.
Oh!
Well, that's not bad at all, really.
He's got a chance for
yeah, he can get he can get the four, at least the six and the ten. Let's see what happens. Gets them both. Two big pins. Now, most important, that Gerald Cormier now goes over to the other lane. He's in the 10th.
Here's the situation. Spare and strike on the spare for Gerald Cormier.
Got all right. He's got the four horsemen set up, one, two, four, and seven. And this is a shot he must miss if he wants to, must make, rather. He must make this shot if he wants to go to the semifinal. Oh, dear. Oh, my. That's really a shame because that ball just got away from him.
Yeah.
He knew it.
He's just had a real problem today with
that's really a shame. Going back. Gerald Cormier gets a good round of applause, and rightfully so. Boy, the Bucktooth native, he bowled well in the first round, bowled well here, and just came up short. Now, the only guy that can catch Bill Grover is this man, Robert Slonwhite. He needs two marks. He's 11 down from second place. Well, he's going to have a chance. Wait a
much better chance. Look at that! Unbelievable!
Well, I want to tell you something. He still has to be on the pin. That, it's a little difficult to tell whether that wood is frozen. That's the important thing. It's got. If it's frozen, he can get it on the wood. Looks like it might be. The one thing, if he misses, he wants to miss on the right-hand side. Look at the concentration. He must make this shot.
Got it.
Well, don't go away.
Pressure is on Bill Grover now, who's sitting in his seat watching Robert Slonwhite bowl.
Robert is still down by. Needs to mark here. Needs to get some work. Get some help there. He's
had the late action again.
He's got six on, and he's got a great
wood
chance to mark. There's no doubt about it.
Bill Grover.
What he wants to do is lay this right in here. He's got a nice piece of wood over here that should carry the 10. He's got to get in here. Here's the shot.
Need a spare.
Oh, he's not going to get it. Oh, what a heartbreaker. Indeed for Robert Slonwhite and Bill Grover.
Reaching back to
a little sigh of relief.
Received congratulations from a member of the audience.
Just a great, great finish. And Robert Slonwhite looked like he had the good spare chance set up. And gets congratulations there, as you see. But this, indeed, was a classic match. A good three-way battle for that second and final spot. But it's going to go to Bill Grover.
Best one we've had to date. So it'll be Bill Grover and Barry Sauer advancing. And we'll talk to the Coca-Cola Bowler of the Week right after this.
We've come together. One airline flying to more destinations in this country than any other. One airline in Canada serving more continents than any other. One airline providing the alternative business travelers demand. One airline called Canadian. The spirit takes wing.
Is this a private party or can any score crush? So, Coke is irresistible.
This is more modern. You said the P word.
So, what I want to know is, if you're drinking Coke, who's drinking Pepsi?
You said the P word!
If you can't beat it, that's the way.
When it comes to giving you more variety, Shoppers Drug Mart never misses, because on average, every store has in total 30% more selection of health and beauty products, more shampoos, deodorants, headache and cold remedies, 30% more. More brands, more sizes, more of everything you want in drugstore selection. Come on, Ben. Ben! Set, must be lunchtime. He's heading for the batteries.
Shoppers Drug Mart, everything you want in a drugstore.
C100, the summer, and you. The station that reaches the beaches is White Rock. Less talk, C100.
That's it for the second week of round two. It went by very quickly. Barry Soward blew away the others, 29 points ahead of the second place finisher, Bill Drover. But from there down, it was a tight, tight race, only 9 points separating second place from fourth place. So one of the more exciting matches we've had here on the number seven Men's Candlepin Championship. Congratulations to you, Barry Soward. You certainly got it going in a hurry. I remember from round one, your scores were pretty mediocre, you know, on your average. Today, round your first string, 147, you were blowing them away in a hurry.
Well, I just had things going for me the first string. It kind of, when you get a start like that, it helps you get a little looser. The first time I was on, it was the first time for something like that, and I really wasn't throwing any kind of ball that I was capable of throwing, and I was lucky to get in with the score I did, but this time I knew with these guys here, especially Bill Drover, where he bowled so well the first time, that I had to have some good scores, and things went well the first string.
You're our Coca-Cola Bowler of the Week. We say hello to Jamie Smith from Coca-Cola.
Hi, Jamie.
Thanks for being here, Jamie. And Jamie will be presenting this material to our champion today, Barry Soward. Of course, we have two champions because Bill Drover advances as well to the second round, or the third round, what we will call the semifinals. Next week, our third week of the second round, we'll be meeting Ron Landry from Acadiaville, Keith Wade from Camelton, Terry Tubb of Riverview, and Stephen Webb of Bedford. That is in our next episode of the number seven Men's Candlepin Championship here on ATV. Hope you can join us then. It's been a terrific week. I think the bowling will be just as good next week. We're with winners now as we go on. All of these people having made it through the first round, the second week round continues in our next episode. Hope you'll be with us. Bye-bye, everybody.